it's Sarah and welcome back to my channel. I am so happy today because today we're doing something super duper fun. We will be testing out four of the most popular SSDs for your PS5. Now we're doing this with the goal of helping us figure out which is the best SSD to use for our PS5. And with that said, let me introduce to you the candidates. First off, we have the Western Digital SN850, the Samsung 980 Pro, the Auros Gen 4 7000S, and the Sabrent Rocket 4 Plus. Can we really notice the difference between them? Well, that's what this video is here so that we can find out. So let's get started. The first test we ran was the read speed benchmark test that starts automatically when you format the drive. First up, the Samsung Pro 980. It came back reading 5749 megs per second, and that seemed slow to me. Turns out, I had an older firmware on it, and apparently, once you upgrade the firmware on the Samsung, it unlocks the speed. If you recently bought the drive, you shouldn't have to worry, but if you bought it a while ago like I did, you can use Samsung Magician software to update it. So we updated the firmware on it, and now let's run it again and see what we get. See, that's more like it. We get 6458 megs per second. Next up is the Western Digital SN850, and we get 6541. And then we try the Gigabyte, and we get 6540. Finally, we have the Sabrent Rocket 4 Plus, and it does really well at 6526. So all four drives are pretty much the same and within any variance you can expect by running the test again. Next, we do a transfer test to see how long it takes to move Ratchet & Clank from the internal SSD to the expansion SSD. Okay, let's speed it up a little bit here. Okay, so they're all within tenths of a second with each other, with the Auros and the SN850 in the top spot. Alright guys, so for me, not enough difference to make me pick one over the other based on that test alone. Next, we move Ratchet & Clank from the expansion SSD back to the internal drive. Again, let's speed it up here because, I mean, who likes watching a loading screen bar, right? Alright, once again, the Auros and the Western Digital come in first, and second with the Samsung super close behind again. The Rocket 4 Plus is 3 seconds behind, but not too significant considering all of them took about 2.5 minutes to transfer. Next, we do a load test from the PS5 home screen to the game title screen of Days Gone, which is a PS4 game. Let's speed it up here again, just a tad bit. Okay, it's a photo finish, you guys. The Mark Cerny drive comes in first this time, but all of them load within a tenth of a second of each other. The Sabrent is really hanging in there, and that's nice to see. Now, from the title screen, let's see how long it takes to get to the game. Speed it up again a little bit here, and alright, what do you know? Another tight finish. The Western Digital is the clear winner here, but again, all of them are really close behind, with the Samsung in second place this time. So now that we know all the drives perform pretty close to each other, let's compare one of them to the internal PS5 SSD drive and an external hard disk drive. Again, we are going to load Days Gone from the PS5 home screen. And again, we'll speed it up too. So look at this, guys. The SN850 actually beats out the internal PS5 drive by a second. And not surprisingly, the external HDD takes much longer. So let's see how long it takes these same three drives to load the game from the game title. speed it up a little here. Okay, the WD again comes in first with the internal drive a few seconds behind. So this is actually interesting because this may potentially open the door to upgrading your PS5's loading performance throughout the lifespan as better drives come out. With that said, there probably will be a bottleneck at some point. Now how about one of my all-time favorite games ever, God of War. From the PS5 home screen to the title screen. Let's not speed it up because I love the music. And again, the WD beats the internal PS5, with the external coming in at 40 seconds. And now we're going to load the game. Will the WD come in first again? And it does. Okay, let's move on to PS5 games. Now, the thing about the PS5 game experience is that they get so creative with loading with cutscenes and animations that you don't even realize that the game is even loading. So that's why here with this game, we're going to skip these cutscenes to try to see if we can spot any differences between the drive. Okay, so here we go. I did not even notice a difference. Did you guys? You can't tell. So let's see if we can spot any difference if we slowed it down. So here we're really slowing it down at 5% speed, and you can see the Western Digital seem to light up and load fully, but we're talking milliseconds. To me, they are just all super close. Looking one more time, you can see the Gigabyte load the first frame first, but then the Western Digital seems to load all the frames fully first. Let's try it again in full speed. Nope, can't notice. Don't notice a difference. Okay, let's try another PS5 game, Returnal. So, Returnal is a game where you jump into a game straight from the home screen for that seamless PS5 experience. Okay, so here I see the Sabrent load just a tiny bit behind, but still close. That really doesn't bother my gaming experience at all, but will it bother some of us just knowing that it's not the fastest? Probably, but maybe it shouldn't. Okay, now let's try Resident Evil 8. From title screen to loading into a game. I can't tell a difference at all, guys. We're gonna have to slow it down again. Okay, let's put it in super slow mode and see. So, looks like the Western Digital loads first, but the others are just a frame or two behind. We're really splitting hairs here. Yeah, it's really close. Alright guys, so what does this all mean? I think it means that it doesn't really matter which one you get because they all perform really well. But if you do want to spend a little less, the Sabrent can hold its own. However, if you're also one of those types of people who feel like they need to have what's the fastest in the bunch, then the Western Digital always seems to come in first and second, even though, you know, you won't really be able to tell the difference in the real world because I mean, who counts things by the millisecond? Am I right? Yes, of course I'm right. Anyway, bottom line is they all work really well and you can't go wrong with any of them. And that's all that I have to say about that. As always, if you guys like this video, do let me know in the comments down below and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and to hit that subscribe button. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.